Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My 25 pound weight loss journey has finally come to an end. We'll show you guys my results in a few. I just want to do a quick recap on what I did throughout the 31 days of trying to lose 25 pounds. For the first half of my weight loss journey, so that was from the first, I think I weighed in, was it like the 21st or the 22nd? I can't remember 100%. Some of the things I incorporated in my diet was the apple cider vinegar, which I took every morning religiously. That with with some lemon in the water as well. So I'll take 2 teaspoons of the apple cider vinegar with 1 whole lemon, and I'll usually just cut up lemon, put it in. But now what I actually do now is I actually squeeze the lemon juice into the water, and I might just throw the remainder of the lemon in the water just to have it in the water. I also was incorporating my raspberry ketone. So this one right here is my favorite brand, only because there is no time restriction. With this one, you could take it 2 tablets right before a meal, right before your biggest meal. The ones I was taking before, you have to take it like 45 minutes or 30 minutes before every meal. And it's not all the time I would remember, you know what I mean? And if I did remember, I was just about to eat or something, so I'm not gonna sit and wait 30 minutes longer while everybody's having dinner and I have to wait for my pills to kick in. So this is one of the reasons why I like this one, because if I do remember right as I'm about to put food in my mouth, there's no problem because you're supposed to take it right before you eat. There's no 30 minute wait. Only time there is a time frame on this is before a workout. It does instruct you to take it 30 minutes before a workout, which I was actually pretty good at. I might have forgotten here and there, or maybe take it maybe 25 minutes until, no, or 15 minutes until a workout. But by the time you actually start getting into your serious workout, half an hour would already pass. And from the first to whenever my first win was, the 22nd, I lost 5 pounds. So very, very pleased with that. And including in all that, I was still doing the intermittent fasting. I did that religiously. I did that every day. I didn't crack once during the first half of my weight loss journey or my weigh-in. So without further ado, I'm going to show you guys the clips leading up to my weigh-in, which I did yesterday. I just didn't have time to do this quick video here because it was the last day of the month at work, and it was just crazy and I was in no mood. I was tired. So I promised myself that I would get it done today and upload it today. So literally when you guys see this, is the exact same day that I recorded this part of the video. So I'm going to show you guys some clips leading up to my last weigh-in. So here it is. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So as I told you guys in my last video that I was going to step it up a notch in regards to my weight loss journey. So here I did pick up a bottle of this lean shake. It's a meal replacement. They suggest that you skip a meal and replace it with this. So I decided to give it a try. It says 251 calories. However, that is with milk. And for all that know already, I do not drink milk. I drink almond milk. So that will cut down this calorie intake drastically, because the milk that I usually drink is anywhere between 30 and 60 calories. So just the powder itself with this is only 122. So just adding an extra 30 to 60 calories is not going to be a huge difference. So I may, or it is going to be a huge difference. So I may have 2 of these in one day just to keep me, you know, alive. And then I'll incorporate that with my juicing as well. So I already pre-prepped everything. I cut all the fruits up and everything. So in here is oranges, raspberry, blueberries, blackberry, and carrots, as well as a cup of coconut water, which is in the fridge that I'll take with me to work tomorrow. So I'm only going to be juicing and taking my lean shake throughout the entire day. I'm going to try. I should be pretty full throughout the day, and then I'll go to the gym in the morning, hopefully, and in the evening. So by the 31st, I should lose a good amount of weight. I'm hoping on it. So it did also come with a 7-day meal plan, which I probably won't be following. For one reason, I don't eat breakfast because I do intermittent fasting. I probably won't be able to snack because I do intermittent fasting. The only time I'll be able to do it is lunch, which is when I'm going to have my shake itself, and probably my juicing drink. So this doesn't really work for me, but for all of you out there that need a meal plan, here you go. You guys can try and give this a try, see if it works for you. So that's it. So I'm just going to get ready for bed now. Tomorrow starts a whole new week of my weight loss journey. Tomorrow will be January the 23rd, and I'll be weighing in myself again on January 31st. I've already prepped all my meals for the day. So I have my fruit juice, my fruit smoothie ready in baggies, and I'm gonna take some protein or meal replacement powder with me to work. All I have to do is just go to the grocery store and pick up a box of almond milk, because I have some at work, but it's probably expired by now. So I have to stop by the grocery store before I get to work and pick up a box of almond milk. So that is all. So tomorrow's a whole new week, a whole new journey in a sense. I'm gonna be living on liquids throughout the majority of the day, and then when I get home, I'll have dinner with the family. So hopefully I'll be able to hit my mark by now and the 31st. If not, my body will have a serious cleanse. That's all I gotta say. So I'm actually getting my water ready for the night. So my water. So what I have in here is some lemon juice and cucumbers. I'm just gonna fill it up with some water right now and call it a night. I'm also going to be drinking some of my apple cider vinegar. I have been lacking on this. So I'm going to drink it tonight because I saw somewhere on YouTube that it's better to drink it before you go to bed. So I'm actually going to drink 2 tablespoons of this and then have my water for the rest of the night until I fall asleep. So that's it. Wish me luck. So now that you guys seen what I was doing for the last couple weeks of my weight loss journey to lose 25 pounds, it is time to see my final results. So here we go. So, as you guys seen by now, that I did not lose any weight whatsoever. I'm still at 239. I didn't lose a pound. I didn't gain a pound, but I didn't lose any either. And as you guys seen, I totally changed my eating routine. I only took my meal replacement for the day, and then I was juicing when I was still hungry, and I'd only have a solid meal at the end of every night. And I did that for 5 days straight. 5 days straight. So I did that for one whole week. And then the following week, I pretty much did the same thing. The only thing I did not do anymore was the juicing, because I ran out of fruits and didn't have time to go back to the grocery store to buy any fruit. So all I did was I did my meal replacement. I would have 2 of those a day. And as you guys seen that I showed you, the powder alone is 122 calories, and the almond milk that I was using was only 30 calories. So it wasn't that much calories I was consuming in a day before I had a solid meal. And then on top of that, I was going to the gym and working out for like 2 hours. And with that being said, I didn't lose a single pound. Yeah, it is a little disappointing, but at the same time, I am not that upset, because I have come a long, long down way. I'm gonna insert some footages and maybe some videos just to show you my journey so far, and I'm very proud very proud of myself. So I'm not gonna knock myself down. I'm just gonna try harder next time. The only thing I could say I did different in the last 2 weeks of my diet is my water totally decreased. I hardly drank a lot of water. What else? I stopped taking my apple cider vinegar. It's not that I wanted to, it's just I always forgot. I never took it in the morning, I never took it at night. My water was gone. My water intake was horrible. That's it. That's the only two things I can think about. So I actually went on Google yesterday to find out what kind of things will put you at a standstill, because I could be at a plateau again right now and I might have to do some other things to confuse my body to start burning off more fat. So I googled some information about plateaus yesterday, and it said it could be many things. It could be the fact that I wasn't drinking water. That was one of the big things. I need to start drinking more water, guys. Like, this is ridiculous. I don't drink nearly enough water as I should and as I need to. My organs are probably like dying of thirst right now, but I really need to up my water, and I think that will definitely help with the weight loss as well, because they say just drinking water, you pee fat. So if just drinking a little bit more water is gonna help me pee some fat, I don't understand what the problem is. So I'm definitely gonna give myself a water challenge or something. I need to drink enough water. So I'm gonna try and execute that for the time being. So from the 1st to the 17th, and try and make it a lifestyle change to drink more water. It could be the fact I was consuming more calories than I was burning, which I'm pretty religious on inputting my calories in my Fitness Pal. If you guys are not following me yet, do follow me. I'm pretty religious in putting my calorie intake in my Fitness Pal, and it's not that often I went over. Actually, I can't even say that I did go over. The only thing I can say is I would eat the amount of calories I was supposed to, but because I worked out, it set me at the right goal. Like, if you understand what I mean. Like, so for example, I was only supposed to consume 1300 calories, but I would burn, say, 300 calories. So that would only leave me with 1,000, but then I'd eat another 300 calories and it put me back at 1300. And I think I read somewhere that defeats the purpose. So even though my calorie intake is 1300, I still technically ate more if I didn't work out. So what it's suggesting is that I should eat at my calorie intake and then burn off 300 of that. So there's a whole bunch of different information on there. Some that I feel did really affect me, like my water. It said sleep. I don't get a lot of sleep. Water, sleep, my calorie intake. That's all I can say. So through the whole month, guys, I only lost 5 pounds. Is it 5 or 6 pounds? Whatever. I didn't lose 25 pounds in 31 days. I only lost 5. So, again, not mad. Very proud of myself on how far I've come in such a short period of time. It's only been, a couple months. Some people, it takes them a year to lose as much weight as I did within a couple months. So I'm very pleased with myself. I'm not going to knock myself down. I'm not going to get discouraged and stop working out. None of that. I'm just going to try harder for the next time. I want to stick to what I was doing before, because that was working for me. Going for smaller goals. I think the goal was too big, so it was harder to hit. You know what I mean? Well, obviously. Next event coming up right now is Valentine's Day, and me and my boyfriend are planning to go out for dinner. And there is this skirt that I got that I want to wear that I've tried on already, and it looks damn good on me. Guys, are you seeing this freaking skirt on me right now? This is a freaking large. It went over my ass. Holy shit. So, I just want to lose another 5 pounds or so before now and the 17th of February. So that is my new challenge to myself, is to lose the 5 pounds from now until February 17th. So the challenge goes on, guys. It doesn't end here. I am only gonna continue to move forward. You guys already know, my goal is to be at my goal weight, which is 180 by now, and I think it was May, June. So I still have some time to go, and I'm already at 239. And when I started this, I was at 265. So it's only up from here and down from my weight. Don't get discouraged, even though when you're trying to hit a mark and it doesn't work. Don't get discouraged. Just find another game plan and try and execute it a different way. And I think I have to go back to the drawing board to switch it up a little bit, because I may have hit my plateau. Because also I did read that your body will get to a certain weight and you have to switch it up. So it could be the fact that my body has burned enough fat based on the activities that I've been doing. So the way I've been eating, the way I've been working out, my body probably reached its limit at that point. So now I gotta switch it up and maybe not eat as much carbs as I was before. More working out, more exercise, more cardio. I'm gonna switch it up and do more cardio, and probably not gonna do much weight right now. I'm gonna probably switch it up and do more cardio, less carbs. I'm not gonna cut out carbs completely, but it's gonna be fewer carbs, more cardio. So that is what I'm going to be doing for the remainder of the 1st to the 17th, is just straight cardio and fewer carbs. I hope this was helpful for you guys. For the ones that were rooting for me to lose the 25 pounds, don't be disappointed. Don't feel sad for me, nothing like that, because I'm not sad. I've come a long way, and I'm just going to continue to go. I'll see you guys next time. Tried it on, and immediately I knew that it couldn't fit. So this is a dress here. The material of this dress is amazing. Plus, it is very stretchy.